Welcome. In this video, we'll see the timer peripheral present in 8051. So timer is a multi-bit counter generating a signal at its overflow. So using timer, we can count the clock pulses. So this overflow signal is used to generate an internal interrupt for the microcontroller. So microcontroller will come to know that the timer has overflowed. So 8051 has two such 16-bit upcounting timers, which are called as timer 0 and timer 1. So this is how the timer works. So whenever we operate the timer, it is having an internal register. Now, this is an example of a 2-bit counter. But in 8051, we have a 16-bit counters or timers. So those will be having a 16-bit registers. So here in this example, there are only 2-bit registers because it is a 2-bit counter. So whenever we give a clock pulse as an input to the counter, the value present in counter is incremented by 1. So initially, let us assume that the value is 00. So when a first clock pulse is given, at every falling edge of that clock pulse, the value will be incremented by 1. So the value has become 01 from initial value of 00. On next clock pulse, again on next falling clock pulse, the value is again incremented by 1. So the next value is 2, which is represented as 10. On next clock pulse, again the value will be incremented by 1, and the next value is 3, which is represented as 11. And finally, if one more clock pulse is given, then the next value is not available, or it is not possible to represent using 2 bits, because the next value will be 4. So now the timer overflows. So again, the timer will roll back to the initial value. So the initial value was 00. And at the same time, it will generate a signal which is called as interrupt. So this signal can be used to interrupt the CPU. And CPU will come to know that timer has overflowed. So this is how a timer works. So the basic difference between a timer and a counter is the clock input. So in the first figure, we have a timer, and in the second figure, we have a counter. Now internally, both of these are going to have resistors, which are called as counter resistors, and the clock pulse which is given to the input of these resistors, counter resistors, that is different for timer and for counter. For timer, the CPU clock or the processor clock which is present, that is given as the input to the counter resistors, whereas for a counter, the clock pulse or the clock input for these counter resistors is taken from the external signal. So that is the basic difference. The clock signal which is given as the input to the counter resistor decides the mode of operation of the timer. So the timer which is present in 8051, that can be operated in two modes, basic modes, that is, it can be used as a timer or it can be used as a counter. So this is how it can be used as a timer, and this is how it can be used as a counter. So there are two timers, that is timer 0 and timer 1, present in 8051. These timers can be operated in different modes. The modes available for timer 0 are mode 0, 1, 2 and 3, whereas the modes available for timer 1 are mode 0, 1 and 2. And the vector address for timer 0 is 000B hex, and the vector address for timer 1 is 001B hex. So the use of this vector address is to write the interrupt service routine. For example, whenever we are using timer 0, and whenever this timer 0 overflows, it will generate an interrupt. So whenever such interrupt is generated, the program counter will jump to the vector address. So that is the use of this vector address. So this is the internal block diagram for the timers, that is timer 0 or timer 1. So as we can see here, we have different blocks. The first block here is the on-chip oscillator. So this on-chip oscillator is used to generate the clock signal from a crystal. This clock, which is generated by the on-chip oscillator, is again internally divided by 12, and then it is given to the further circuitry. Here, the first switch is used to control the clock source of the timer. So here, if the switch is connected to the first line, then the internal clock is given as input to the further circuit. Whereas if this switch is connected to this second line, then the clock which is available on TX line, that is either T0 or T1 line, that will be taken as clock source input. So whenever this switch is present at first line, then it is operating in timer mode, and whenever this switch is connected to the bottom line, that is this second line, that at that time it will be acting as a counter, because external clock pulses is given as the input to the timer. So this switch can be controlled with the help of a bit called as C/T bar, which is present in TMOD resistor. Next, the output of this block is given to one more switch, which is again controlled by another circuitry. So this circuit has again three different options. So first bit is TRX bit. This can be either TR0 or TR1. This is called as timer run control bit. So if this bit is 1, only then timer will start, and if this bit is 0, then timer will be off. Then using this gate bit, we can control the timer using some external signal. So for example, if this gate bit is 1, it means that whatever signal is available on this INTX pin, that signal will control the running and stopping of the timer along with the TRX bit. So this bit should be 1, only then the timer will be on. Next, if we want to control the timer using external signal, this gate bit should be 1. And at that same time, whenever there is a low signal on this pin, only then the timer will start counting. If there is a high signal on this pin and TRX bit is 1, gate bit is 1, still the timer will be off. So that is how we can control the timer using the external signal along with the TR bit. Then after that, the output of this switch is given to the timer resistors. So there are two timer resistors, TL0 or TL1 and TH0 and TH1. So these are both of 8 bits. So total 16 bit resistors are there, which hold the timer count value. So whenever a clock signal is given as an input to these resistors, the value present in these resistors will be incremented by 1. So whenever the maximum value is reached, so since it is a 16 bit resistor, the maximum value will be FF hex. So whenever one more clock pulse is given, at that time the value will roll back to 0000 hex, and at the same time the overflow flag of that particular timer will be set to 1. So this TFX flag becomes 1 to indicate that the timer has overflowed. So this is the block diagram of timer available in 8051. So the three functional blocks are present in these two timers. The blocks are signal source selection for timer counter, then run stop control logic, and the counting configurations in different modes. So this is about the timers. In the next video, we'll see the SFRs, which are associated with controlling or configuring the timers. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.